Hello everyone, once again, this is Rob, and welcome back to Media Awareness and another first reaction video. Before I continue, however, a reminder, the fundraiser continues. For those of you new to my channel or unaware, I am a disabled individual, and I use a motorized wheelchair / scooter all day every day for my independence, and I need your help. My insurance will not cover anything with regard to my scooter, as they view it as a, quote, luxury item, end quote. Despite the fact that I am unable to walk whatsoever, in addition to being unable to use any other type of power chair, or even a standard wheelchair for that matter, as I only have limited use of one hand. In addition to that, I do not have a backup scooter or wheelchair, so if this malfunctions, as it recently did, I will be yet again a fish out of water, a scenario I want to avoid at all costs. With all of that stated, below the title of this video in the description, as well as in a separate section below the information pertaining to the video I'm going to be reacting to, you will find a fundraiser link. It's a spot fund link. Any and all contributions are welcome. Even $5 or $10 helps and adds up over time. And it will definitely help in this case. At the current time, I am endeavoring to both refurbish my existing scooter as well as to obtain a new scooter as well. In light of what recently occurred, I feel that's necessary. I'm going to digress momentarily and explain that. I was recently without power to my scooter for roughly 2 weeks. The battery charging mechanism had failed entirely and needed to be replaced. And much of the fundraising funds went to both obtain the part necessary as well as to pay the trained technician to install the part and pay him for his time. So, with all of that stated, I'm trying to recoup that loss, but also trying to basically put aside the money for a new scooter, as well as to continue the ongoing refurbishing of this scooter, so that when I have a new scooter, my existing scooter can become my backup, and I will never be in a situation where I am without my independence. I strive to be independent, and I thrive on my independence on a daily basis. And although I'm not completely independent, I do really, really pride myself on the things I can do. And not being able to do those things for a two-week time frame really, really was traumatizing beyond what I can convey here. And it really did a number on me, and I don't want to be in that situation ever again. So please do what you can. Like I said, even $5 or $10 helps out. It's easy to contribute. Click on the link. It takes a few seconds. You can even contribute anonymously, and any and all support is welcome. I do want to really extend a gracious thanks to those who have contributed thus far, in addition to those who plan on contributing, as your contributions have and will make a world of difference in my life. Thank you all. I love you all. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel, Media Awareness, and become part of my YouTube family. I'd love to have you. Also, please like and share, and also click the bell icon to be notified whenever I upload something new. That way you don't miss out on it as it goes live immediately. So, with all of that stated, here we go, along with this reaction. So, continuing with this, I'm covering the Oasis performance on the Jools Holland show from November 2nd of 2000 in support of the Standing on the Shoulders of Giants album with that band lineup. And we are on, I believe it's track 8. I've been doing this for 8 weeks. Wow, time flies. But we're more than halfway through the actual performance on the Jools Holland show. So this is exciting for me, as I am a huge Oasis fan, as many of you may know, and this is really one of my favorite songs, Rock and Roll Star. Of course, the opening track on Definitely Maybe, that their first album, and it was actually the first song I heard in its entirety when I bought the album, and I was just captivated, blown away. The intensity of the performance on the record, as well as the phenomenal tight musicianship and just the attitude really won me over. And looking forward to seeing this performance of this on the Jools Holland show. So, with all my reactions, you know the drill. If you do not, you're about to learn. What I do is I do link the source video below. I do this because the musicians and bands who create this music for us, the fans, do so with the utmost creativity and integrity, and they deserve all the credit in the world for their hard work. In this case, whoever uploaded this video and it is remastered deserves the credit for that and for making it available to us Oasis fans. So please click on that link and you'll be able to watch the show in its entirety, as opposed to simply seeing me reacting to one track more than halfway through the show itself. So with all of that stated, and with the Oasis reunion basically on the horizon in 2025, I am filming this in late October of 2024. I'm excited despite the fact there are no US dates announced as of yet. I am a huge Oasis fan and I'm really excited for this. I really am. So, and I'm ready to do this reaction. So, like I said, just click on that link below to watch the entire Jools Holland performance. And you can also watch it with optimum video and audio quality, and without me in the corner of the screen up there somewhere like an untrained mime in the box. So, yes, here we go. Oasis with Rock and Roll Star from November 2nd of 2000 on the Jools Holland Show in support of the album Standing on the Shoulders of Giants. However, Rock and Roll Star itself is the first track on the first Oasis album, Definitely Maybe. Here we go, Rock and Roll Star from 2000.
We probably know this one, haven't you?
Yeah.
Be safe. Ride a condom.
So there you have Oasis from November 2nd of the year 2000 in support of the Standing on the Shoulders of Giants tour album. And this was, of course, the performance of the track Rock and Roll Star, which is the first song on the first Oasis album, Definitely Maybe. And I have mixed feelings on this thought, on this performance, to be honest. First, though, I want to apologize. I do not have YouTube Premium or whatever it's called, where you can have no commercials. So there was a commercial in there, which I not so skillfully spliced out. So my apologies for that little interruption not mid-song, but toward the end of the song itself. Certain aspects I really like a lot. I love Liam's attitude in this particular performance. I also love just the sort of carefree nature of the performance of this track. You know, everyone is really into it. It's very almost laid back and very casual. But I have to say the keyboards really, really add a lot. They fill out the sound once again. I've said that through all of these reviews, reactions on this performance, I believe. They really, really fill out the sound. And I can't say that enough because it really makes a difference. And you wouldn't think that it would make that much of a difference, but it really does. You know, it has a whole another textural element in terms of sound and filling out the audio so that way there's no dead space, so to speak. I feel like everyone was really, really good on this performance. Liam was definitely at the top of his game, as was Noel. Wasn't as impressed with Alan on drums in this song. It just didn't, the drum part really kind of threw me off, actually. It didn't quite seem right. It worked at some points, but other points it didn't. Nevertheless, it was still a great performance, and those, you know, guys really should be applauded for this particular appearance on the Jools Holland Show. Like I said before, this is a show that could have been released as a live CD, live DVD, maybe combine it with something else, because there was really a lot of great material performed thus far. We're almost at the end of it. I would estimate roughly maybe a week or two left in this performance. I don't know how many songs they did total, but we are on track 8 this week, Rock and Roll Star. So yeah, there you have my thoughts on Rock and Roll Star. Love what Noel did on guitar at the end with the feedback. That was fantastic. And I love, that's one of the things that always drew me to Oasis, was the use of feedback as an instrument sound in and of itself, and really using feedback in that manner is an art form, and it's really not one that is easy to master, because you really need a good knack for how instruments work, how to get things to sound the way you want them to sound, and how to get the proper amount of feedback at any given time. And you know, Oasis was one of those bands that used feedback to their advantage, and I really like what they did over the years with that. So I really have to applaud Noel on that as well. But yeah, there you have it. Oasis, Rock and Roll Star, once again on the Jools Holland Show, November 2nd, 2000. And once again, it is linked below for your convenience. So click on that link, watch the entire performance from beginning to end, And I have already gotten a few requests for future Oasis coverage. So I'll be continuing weekly, apparently, doing at least one Oasis track a week for an indefinite time frame. I've been asked to do several, looks like here, several performances in their entirety, so I'll be a busy guy here with that, at least on a weekly basis. But in the meantime, I do hope that you enjoyed this reaction video, and please like, share, and comment below. Also, once again, consider subscribing to my channel and becoming part of my YouTube family. I'd love to have you. And once again, the fundraiser continues. Please do what you can. Even $5 or $10 helps out, and it all adds up over time. And once again, you can also contribute anonymously. This is Rob, and I will see you all soon. Have a wonderful morning, noon, or night, wherever you are. Take care. Bye.